this chapter, which can be taken in the entrance as well as for the boards. So first thing, what I want to tell you is Bio Savart's law. Okay, but before that, you have to know some few terms in this chapter. Okay, find few terms you should be able to know in this chapter. So I will be telling you that, for example, if it is B, B stands for magnetic field. Okay, H stands for magnetic field intensity. Fine. So these are the two most important terms in this. Other terms and all, I think you know. I stands for current, R stands for radius and everything. And coming to the first topic, that is Bio Savart law. The most important topic in this. Okay, fine. So Bio Savart law is nothing but it is used to predict the magnetic field, there is MF. I'll write here MF, magnetic field as, correct, in a current carrying wire. That is the purpose of this law. Okay, so just like we got something like F is equal to 1/4πε₀ Q1, Q2 by R square, Coulomb's law, or F proportional to Q1, Q2 by R square. I think this everyone is aware about, Coulomb's law. Correct? Yes. So similarly, for what? Magnetic field also, there is a law that is called Bio Savart law. In the sense, it is nothing but dB proportional to, or dB in the sense, small magnetic field. Proportional to ideal sin theta by R square. dB directly proportional to ideal sin theta by R square. There we had F proportional to what? Q1, Q2 by R square. No, here we got what? Magnetic field, that is dB, correct? Proportional to ideal sin theta by R square. So in the examination, they can ask us state Bio Savart law. Correct? So what do you do right here? dB proportional to, this is the figure for that, don't need to worry. So first I will teach you the shortcut on how to learn this thing, ideal sin theta by R square. In the sense, how do you state this thing? The magnetic field is directly proportional to the current. Maybe in the whiteboard it will be much better. Yeah, the magnetic field is directly proportional to what? The current. The magnetic field is directly proportional to what? Length of the conductor, correct? And magnetic field is directly proportional to what? Sine theta. Magnetic field is inversely proportional to what? Square of distance between them. Is it clear? So if you are able to by heart this one, which one? This particular one. Correct? We can write its own statement. dB. B stands for, I told you, magnetic field. Okay, maybe at the end of session, I can explain you or I can revisit what is magnetic field. But the first 5 to 10 minutes are very important. So dB is what? dB is directly proportional to the current. Yes? dB is directly proportional to the current, I. Magnetic field is directly proportional to the length of the conductor. Magnetic field is directly proportional to the sine theta. Write on same like that. Magnetic field is inversely proportional to the square of distance between them. Clear? So this only they have written down here. And we can find some line like this, no? Yes, there is nothing but my wire. Correct? Current carrying wire. This is my current carrying wire. So what is the purpose of Bio Savart law? To determine the magnetic field in a wire. In wire, in the sense, it carries the current. Current carrying wire. So this is nothing but my current carrying wire. I hope everyone understood. Correct? And there, in the electrostatic force, 1/4πε₀ was there, right? instead of that we got mu by mu naught by 4 pi value. Okay, to remove the proportionality constant, they are given mu naught by 4 pi value. So dB is directly proportional to the ideal sine theta by r square. You can just by heart like this. dB directly proportional to ideal sine theta by r square. Is it clear for everyone? This one. If it is not clear, once the class is over, I'll again come and explain individually. Is it clear for everyone? Let me know. dB is equal to mu naught by 4 pi into ideal sin theta by r square. Is it clear to all? There is no chat option empty. Yeah, perfect. Then I'll go to the next one. Three students have sent me. Let me just go to the next one. I'm taking the first thing, very important thing, okay? Then I'm going to the least important ones. Next one is Ampere circuital law. The previous one was Bio-Savart law. This one is what? Ampere circuital law. Here also, I can write integral of B dot dl is equal to mu naught I. What I written down here? Integral. What does this signifies? This signifies it's a closed loop. This signifies what? It's a closed loop or a closed path, just like a circle. Okay. What is B standing for? Magnetic field. What is DL? Length of the conductor. Mu naught is a constant, so leave it. Correct? I value. I is current. So how do we state this thing? What is this thing? What? To state this thing, see, the line integral. What is this thing? Integral, right? The line integral, the integral of a magnet line. Obviously, it's a current carrying wire. It's a line. The line integral of a magnetic field, correct? And magnetic field is through what? A closed path, right? Correct? Yes? Over a length L is equal to the current enclosed by the path. One more time, I'll just explain this thing. The magnetic field, correct, over a closed path. No need to write closed path in the sense, obviously, it will include the length also. If it's a closed path like this, obviously, it will be including the length also. Correct? You can just write one what? The magnetic field over a closed path is equal to the current enclosed by the path. So basically what I'm telling is magnetic field and current are equal in that particular closed path. Is it clear for everyone? One more time, I'll just write it for you. That's how you have to learn. We cannot integral of B dot dl is equal to mu naught I. And what is this line standing for? Integral. Correct? Integration, integral. If I just draw this, this is the line. But if I draw integration symbol with dl, then it shows what? Then it is integration. The line integration. The line integration, in the sense, it includes the line. Correct? The line integral of magnetic field. The line integral of magnetic field over a closed path is equal to the current enclosed by the path. I'll write down here. The line integral. The line integral of magnetic field, that is B, over a closed path is equal to the current enclosed by the path. This is nothing but my Ampere circuital law. Circuital law, circuit. circular, obviously circuital law. If you only remember integral of b dot dl is mu not I, we'll be able to do the statement by ourselves. If everyone has copied down this thing, let me know. Then a small derivation is there. Once that is done, 50 to 60% of this chapter important topic is covered. These two are very important. Is it done? The copying down of this. I'll be sharing you the PDF also. Okay, the notes of this chapter, a textbook PDF. Later on, I'll be sending you the entrance related programs. Now, this is the Ampere circuital law. Okay, I think everyone has done it. Yeah. And most important thing is the diagram here. It's a kind of elliptical thing, correct? Not circular, I can tell. It's a kind of ellipse. Integral of b dot dl is equal to mu not I. So let's go through that. Yeah. So this is from the Ampere circuital law. This is a dot product. Correct? In the sense, what will come in dot product? Cos theta will come. Work, everything is what? Dot product. So integral of b dot dl cos theta is equal to mu not I. Correct? For to get the maximum magnetic field, to get the maximum magnetic field, theta should be zero, or else you come back to the figure here. We can see one important thing. If I am just zooming on this particular thing, what is one thing we can note down? I think I zoomed too much. Yeah, I think it will be fine. Kindly note down one important thing. I think this will be fine. We can see one important thing, B and DL, correct? Same direction. In the sense, if I want to draw here, I'll take a whiteboard. Okay, and if I want to draw here. If I want to draw this as my B. And then if I want to draw my length L. This is kind of same thing, right? Correct? 0 degree. In the sense, it's going on the same direction. This is my length and this is my magnetic field. It's going in what kind of same only? 0 degree. Correct? Parallel. I can tell it as parallel length. Parallel in the sense 0 degree. There is no deviation. There is no deviation in this. Correct? Yeah. That's the reason I am taking what? Theta as 0. Then only my cos theta will become maximum. One thing is this, the real reason is what? Obviously, directions are same, so theta is 0. Or else, one more thing is, when will I get it maximum? When if I put theta is equal to 0, if I put theta is equal to 0, let me just, yeah. If I put theta is equal to 0, what cos 0 is equal to 1 I will be getting. If I put theta is equal to 90, I'll get what cos 90 value. What is it? Zero. The whole thing will become zero. So I cannot do that. Correct. So I'm getting integral of b dot dl is equal to b naught I. B is a constant, so I can take it outside. Correct. So I'll be getting something called integral of dl. We all know what is integral of dx value, x itself. Integral of dl value is what, length itself. This is along a circular path, in the sense circumference. What is circumference? 2 pi r. Correct? Circumference is what? 2 pi r. Integral of dx is what? X. This is not my u, this is my x. Integral of dx is what? X. Integral of dl is what? L. Correct? This is not a length. This is a circle. Ampere circuital law. You are taking in a circle. So, circumference is what? 2 pi r. So, that I have to substitute. Is it clear? So, instead of integral of dl, what I'll substitute? I'll substitute 2 pi r is equal to mu naught I. So, b I can derive from this. Is it clear for everyone? You can do it later, but I just want to know, is this thing clear? The integration part, is it clear? So if you are unable to get it now, once the class is over, I'll come down and I'll explain to you personally. Okay. Whomever is having doubt, I'll be sending the PDF. So no need to worry. And I think everyone knows what is a solenoid, right? I think the lower classes, class 10th. Yeah. Class 10th, I think. Everyone has learned about solenoid. Has everyone learned about solenoid, or is the first time seeing about it? Okay. Can anyone tell me what is the use of solenoid? Where are the, what is the practical application? Uses of solenoid. I think I'm getting some answers. No, okay. It's like, okay, don't remember. Okay. What do you think are the basic use of solenoid and where it is used? I think class 10th, I think everyone might have studied. Separation of metal from a non-metal. Okay. Correct. Separation of a metal from a non-metal, obviously. Correct. How many of you don't know what is a solenoid? Okay, coming to the boys section, I think how many of you have ridden a scooty or a bike here? Scooty or a bike? At least not a cycle, I'm talking about this thing, scooty or a bike. Yes. So, yes. So I think most of you might have seen or been in the bike, right? So obviously we know that in the bike or the scooty, is there a reverse gear first thing? Is there a reverse gear like in car? So what will happen actually? So in scooty, what energy used to convert what? In the sense, how does it move forward? Because we should be very clear with the practical application. Correct? So obviously it will move forward, the two-wheeler thing. Correct? It will move forward. Yes? But how? On what mechanism thing? In the sense, a scooty or any other, let's take a two-wheeler. I'm telling you this example because we'll remember. We'll have what? A solenoid. In the sense, solenoid is what? It is an electromechanical device. Electromechanical device. Or else I'll write it neatly. Or else, yeah, it won't be good enough. I'll write down here in text. So what is solenoid? It is an electromechanical device. So these things are not there in the text too, okay? Correct. So which uses electrical energy? Yes. Applied. To an electromagnetic coil. Electromagnetic coil in order to produce what? In order to produce the forward mechanical motion. So please copy down this thing. So this is what is actually a solenoid for. Or else, if I just go to a textbook method, let me type it here. Yeah, solenoid. Yeah. See, in textbook method, what is given? It is a cylindrical coil made of large number of turns of insulated conducting wire. In the sense, I draw a cylinder. Let me draw a cylinder. Then what? I'll draw some coils like this. Correct? Large number of turns of wires. Obviously, these are all wires. The black things are all wires. Insulated. In the sense, I'm taking one cylinder, cylindrical rod or something. Correct? And I'm tying it up with what? With wires. We can see it, right? The wires thing. So that is basically my solenoid. But if you learn like that, so it will be just without the practical application. So I hope you understood what it is for now. Has anyone written down this thing? Yeah. So let's come back to the textbook definition. The same thing, whatever I told. It's a cylindrical coil made number of large number of turns of insulated conducting wire. Draw a cylinder, draw some wire, that's it. Insulating, yeah, or a cylinder, that's it. Now let's come back to one more important topic here. Derive an expression for magnetic field due to a current carrying solenoid by using Ampere circuital law. Okay, so that is our question here. So they have just drawn a sectional view of a solenoid, as you can see in the diagram. Okay, so we are using what basically? Integral of B dot dl is equal to mu naught I. Correct? Mu naught I. So I think everyone knows what it is. Correct? Yes. And in a solenoid, let me draw here if it is not drawn properly. So this is cylinder. This is my current carrying wire, right? Basically, this is my current carrying wire. Yes. And how many turns? These are called turns. These things are called turns. There are n number of turns of length L. Correct? So my n will become, so what was my ampere circuital law? Integral of B dot dl is equal to, what is it basically? Integral of B dot dl is equal to, B dot dl is equal to mu naught I. Correct? Yes. This is, if it is an n number of turns, it will be basically what? Integral of B dot dl. I'm not writing the closed integral, okay? But if you want, you can just draw it. Integral of B dot dl is equal to mu naught. Then what it is? N L I. In the sense, I written down what is N I here, no? What is, how many number of terms are there? Currently, I drawn some three turns. But there can be N number of turns, right, of length L. So that's the reason it is N L. Okay. And here, you can see it is a sectional view here. It is a sectional view. Correct. So if I want to make it as a circular or square, with integration, the beauty is that either it can be a circular, square, or anything. Any shape, we can do the integration. So if I'm taking a loop of ABCD, what I'm taking? Integral of ABCD, if I'm taking, of B dot dl, I can split it. So if you want to know how to split it, for example, for that, I'll just draw and show to you. It's not in the textbook. Okay. So if this is the X and Y axis, and now let me draw a square or something. Yeah. Well, it's better than this. I will just mark one thing. I'll mark from here A, B, then maybe C and D. In the sense, points. Okay, I'll make some points and I'll mark. Then I will join everything. A, B, C, D. Okay. Suppose if this is a solenoid thing. Okay, integral of B dot dl. Integral of B dot dl of what? A, B, C, D. Correct? This is equal to what basically? If it is a line integral, I'm talking about line integral. Line in the sense, it is integral of AB plus line integral of BC plus line integral of CD and line integral of DA. Does everyone agree with me in that? Line integral, this is line integral, right? Line integral is what? AB plus BC plus CD plus DA. In the sense, I'll show you here in the textbook. Yes. So it is basically this one, but they're not shown it because this will come in engineering only. Integral of B dl is equal to mu naught N L I. That is fine. But what is my A, B, C, D? As I shown you, it's a line integral. A, B plus B, C plus C, D plus D, A. Correct? And B dot dl, dot product in the sense, cos theta I can put. Same thing only. So I'm getting, what is integral of dl? B, I can take it outside. What is integral of dl? L, B, L. Yes, this is for my line AB. In the sense, the first one. Okay. So I think everyone is comfortable with the this thing. How I'm splitting it, right? Integral of what? AB plus BC plus CD plus integral of DA. This is how I'm splitting it up. I think everyone is clear with it, with this thing. Now, one common sense thing, see here, AB, if I want to see here, very important, just listen for one more minute, that's more than enough. Here, what is it? Magnetic field and length are in same direction. That is the reason cos theta value, I was able to get what? Cos theta, theta is equal to zero. But what about BC? What is the theta value? 90 degree, correct? Perpendicular. Even though I not drawn perpendicular, what is theta value? Perpendicular. What about DA? Theta value is what? Here. DA, 90 degree, right? What is cos 90 value? Zero. Correct? And what about this CD? CD. CD, what is the thing? CD. If this is the magnetic field axis, where is CD coming? CD is outside the solenoid. Outside in the sense, zero. The magnetic field will be zero. Is this thing clear to everyone? How I took the 90 degree and everything? Yeah. So if I substitute all of these things, I'll be getting what? Only AB. So I can directly write down integral of B dot DL is equal to this one here. BL. Mu naught NLI. B is equal to mu naught NI. So don't worry about these equations. They have just substituted in the main equation. Okay. So now I will come down and explain you all the problems you had. Yeah. Everyone can leave the meeting now. Yes.